Right, so I guess so. I was gonna talk. I don't know. I wanted to not talk about the car company idea at the moment. It's just, you know, there's only so much I can do, you know, physically as a human being. I made the numbers. They're on the worksheet there. It's pretty cool. You can determine, you know, the loan ratio, change it. You know, it has all of these really neat little predictors, so it's a good little stat predictor. It fails, it shows the fails, and it shows the loan, you know, loan if you go with a bank loan, and you can, you know, determine how much you want of that bank loan also. So it has a good, you know, like an easy momentum bringer, so I'm kind of happy with it. And yet, I actually don't want to unleash it online. I don't want to give it away too much. It's kind of too great. It's too great a piece of work. It is a piece of work that can be used for many businesses, so I can't really just give it away. It's a do I make profits or not? You know, it's really that's stated, you know. And it's something you could take to any bank and use as your vessel for, you know, do I get the loan, you know, as the precursor to receive the loan. So, yeah. Anyway, so I'm proud of it. It's great. So next. Oh my gosh. Yeah, I like the Wiki sticks. I've had all of these ideas. I had the Wiki sticks, the Google sticks. You know, the little USB, you know, the best of the best of Wiki. And so you can actually have that, you know, when you're offline, when you're not, you don't have internet access, that type of thing. I thought that was going to be a sell. I thought it was going to be a marketable thing. I thought it was going to be out there at Office Max, and I've been waiting for my 1%, you know. I have not received it. I thought it was going to be at Barnes & Noble, you know, just at the checkout. What's going on? You know, where are the Wiki sticks and where are the Google sticks? You know, it's supposed to be there for Christmas. You know, that was about 2 years ago that I stated that. So it hasn't happened. So yet again, another business that is just kind of like, what? You know, who are these anarchists? Who are these anarchists around me? You know, that's a great idea. So, what was I going to say? I don't know. I guess I wanted to talk about something else. I don't know. Everybody's hyped for the cars. Huh? We're all hyped for the cars, you know, another car company. Yeah, I was really hyped for the electric version, an electric version of that old rendition passed into the future, you know, brought into the future. That's real sweet, you know, that's something interesting. And I business idea wise, you know, when I came up with the little cutesy deal where you park the car at night on the ramp and then the car just lowers slowly. And then that charges the turbine engine that charges the electric battery grid of the car. So you don't actually have to plug into the house. You're just on that little ramp all night long. So it's like an 8-hour tug pull all the way from the top to the bottom. And when it actually reaches the bottom, then your battery is completely refilled or topped or whatever. You know, so yeah, it was kind of fun because I think about places like cabins, or you know, places where you don't have huge energy grid available, and so you could be like off grid charging your car. It's kind of an interesting little perk that you could add with sales, you know, with any of the electric motor cars. So yeah, that was a kind of a neat idea. I figured somebody was going to jump on that one and say, hey, here's your 1%, you know, haven't been contacted. So I am a little kind of, I don't know, perplexed. You know, as if, you know, Why am I being downed? You know, why am I being downed? Why? You know, like I said, I haven't killed anybody. I don't get it. I just don't get it. So, anyway, yeah. I briefly did want to talk about something interesting I was reading about the right and the left side of the brain. I know it's a complete switch. The left and the right side of the brain. Now, the left side, interestingly enough, there's a sector of the brain that has stories, made-up stories, and in that very same sector is shared fact. So fact and stories exist on the left side of the brain, and truth, is on the right side of the brain. So it's kind of odd, because truth is almost switched off into the instinct, and yet, so here we are with stories running like pretty much close together with fact. And so that becomes an odd problem I'm seeing with individuals, where they cross over and they have a story that they think is fact, when in reality it is still a story. So somewhere in the brain, there must be something that is taking that synaptic and almost welding it together with the fact synaptic, the story synaptic of made up. And when I mean made up, I've met people that are just compulsive liars. So when they are in this story place, their whole lives about things and people and just, you know, they're destroyers, they're destructive. When they're compulsive liars, there must be something there that has glued that story area into the fact area of the left side of the brain. So I guess there must be some kind of a, you can say it's an over-acceptance, where I mean, do stories even exist in their head? Do they even know stories any longer? You know, the compulsive liar, do they even know stories any longer? Or is everything fact? Has everything become fact? Just as this past week, you know, it's your birthday. I'm like, no, it's not my birthday. You know, you told me it was your birthday. No, I didn't tell you ever it was my birthday. You know, so these types of things, you know, where the person is so structurally oriented into the story as a fact, it's almost like it's become a square place of being where those things exist together. And they're locked in. So the fact and the story are locked together, and they can't be separated. And it's just like, oh, it's so tedious to actually keep trying to say, no, it's not my birthday. It's not my birthday. Just no, it is not my birthday. You know, again and again and again. You know, to explain. When the believer is so tight, they're so tight in the fact, they are so tight, you know. Yeah, it's almost like when you take the weight, you take the weight of the story and you take the weight of the fact area and you put it together, you get a double weight. So maybe that's where they're coming from. They have the weight of the story and the weight of the fact. So instead of the weight of one, they have the weight of two. Do you understand what I'm saying? But either way, truth is allocated to the right side of the brain. So that's a big zonk over there. Truth is on the right side of the brain. So it has to be like, yeah. I mean, so the held factor, the library of it, you know, the library of the story, the library of the fact, that has to actually be opened up for a second and go visit truth. Now, if it doesn't like to get opened up any longer, if that library is staying in a locked, closed door and does not like to go visit truth, now truth is over there. So here you have that structurization locked in that does not ever want to go visit truth. So I guess that's what I'm seeing, you know. It's your birthday today, you know. So when you're seeing somebody, it's saying that straight to you, and you know it's not your birthday because that's truth, and yet they are exclaiming it as fact, that story, they're exclaiming it as fact. You know, they're speaking from that locked place in the brain. Anyway, so that was just my little interesting update on, it's not my birthday. Yeah, I got in trouble with Facebook because it goes through and it checks your birthday, and I'm like, what? I can't remember the birthday I gave them, because I always give them different birthdays, you know. I can't remember, so I can't get back into the account. So go ahead and write whatever you want to be mean, extra. I can't manage it. Anyway, good night.